Hopefully you've seen the part one video already, because we're going to jump right into this one. Now, I think it's important that we go over the mold making process again for this one, like we have in my other videos, because the mold making is what's involved with the vacuum chamber. In the last one, we use a pressure pot to remove bubbles from the resin. Now we're going to use a vacuum chamber to remove the bubbles from the silicone. So what I'm doing here is gluing dice to other dice. The polyhedral set that I'm using here is the ones that I want to replicate, and I use the little red dice as sprues, or essentially funnels for where the resin's going to go into, because anything that I cover in silicone is going to be inverted into the silicone mold shape. So what I do here is I glue them down inside Dixie cups like this. It lets the dice stand up, and wherever the little mini six-sided dice is at the top is where I'm going to actually pour the resin in to fill up the rest of the dice. You can really use anything you want as a sprue as long as it's enough to catch the resin. I just like using the dice because the single pip on there is something easy to glue it onto. So I go ahead and glue all these up. You've noticed that I have one black dice that I'm going to use here. I'm actually going to use this as a control or a test group for something that I saw in the comments. Someone told me that they don't need to use a vacuum cleaner, they just paint their silicone on instead of pouring it in. So I'm using silicone, the Slow 15 series. It's a platinum-based silicone. It is phenomenal. I have never had any problems with tackiness in my dice, and so this is the one that I recommend now. I used to recommend the Slow 30 or the Fast 30, but this one's good. I haven't had any problems with it without having to bake it or cure it or anything like that. So we're gonna go ahead and mix up a set here, and this first set is the one that we're going to paint onto this black dice. So shout out to Austin Thibodeau, because he's the one who commented and gave me the idea for this, and he said what he does is paint over it with the intention that the painting helps pop a lot of the bubbles on there from the silicone, so there's no bubbles for the pressure pot to mess up, so you can't have any of those spiky surface bubbles like I saw before. So what he said was go ahead and just paint over the whole thing in silicone and then immediately pour it over. So that's what I do. I paint on one side, then I glue it down into the bottom of a cup just like normal. Immediately try and paint over the rest, that way I can get everything painted and not just pour it on. But then he said don't wait, so I painted on and immediately started pouring silicone over the rest of it, because I think if it started falling off the bottom, you'd have issues. Now we've got our control group that we can test against for another idea. Let's get to the main meat of this video, which is using a vacuum chamber. I got an eBlaze vacuum kit, which comes with an acrylic lid that has a nice rubbery seal that goes around it, as well as little gauges for you to open up with a ball valve on the inside. I got the 1.5 gallon size one. I didn't need the 3 gallon one. I figured this would work just fine for me. It comes with a nice little silicone bottom so that your stuff doesn't slide around whenever you're trying to use the vacuum inside, and I definitely highly recommend that or else it will fall over. And it comes with the actual vacuum pump. It's not the same as an air pump. It does take oil to use, and it comes with the hose. I had to buy the hose for the air pump before, but this hose comes with it, and you just put it right on there so that you can suck the air out of the vacuum chamber. It also doesn't come with oil, so be wary of that. You may forget it. I only noticed because I saw in the comments saying, hey, you need to buy your own on this one. So take the cap off, fill it up with oil to the line that it tells me to do, take the specific air hose cap off, tie it on, and make sure that it's really tight or else it's going to be hard to pull the vacuum. Put that onto the ball valve there for the lid, and you're essentially good to go. What this valve does is when it's open, it sucks the air out of it. If it's closed, the vacuum is not doing anything anymore. This thing over here is a filter so that when you open it back up and let the air in, dust doesn't come in. This little ball valve here closes off the vacuum, so if you wanted to pull a vacuum and leave it, you're fine to do that, but this one is mostly gonna have to be continuously pulled since we're trying to constantly pull bubbles out of it. There's a lot of moving parts to it and it's kind of complex, so it's easier to just show you rather than try to explain it. So let's do that. Let's mix up another batch of silicone, and this time I'm going to put it into 2 cups, because if it were so full like that, it may actually pull the silicone out and over. So we take the lid off, put the silicone in, close it up, and now we're gonna go ahead and start the vacuum. With the vacuum on and the cap closed on the blue end, we can open up the red cap, and it's now starting to suck air out of that chamber. Eventually, it runs out of air on the inside and starts to suck air out of the silicone, and this happens. If you got tryptophobia, this is gonna mess with you. All of those little bubbles and things popping on the top is tiny holes that would have caused imperfections in your silicone. You can see here, if I open the cap, it can't pull air out of the silicone because there's easier air to get with the cap open. So don't do that. You want to make sure that your cap's closed. I let this run for about 5 to 7 minutes. After a while, you can see much less bubbles come out of it than used to, and they're starting to slowly pop. Eventually, Once I say, all right, that's good enough, I open this up so that no more bubbles are coming out and the lid comes off super duper easy and you've got ready to use silicone for your pressure pot. Now we can start making our molds out of silicone. Another tip is to pour this extremely high. I'm told that helps get rid of bubbles. I don't know myself, but it seems to work by the end of this video. So we'll go ahead and try that out. Now, I didn't make quite enough, but that's okay. We've got our own vacuum chamber now, and we can mix the resin up, and it's not a hard process. This whole thing takes me 10 to 15 minutes, 5 minutes for mixing the silicone, 5 to 7 minutes for actually putting it in the vacuum chamber, and voila, we're done. We've got enough silicone that we can make pressure pot ready silicone molds. Now, with these molds, I just go ahead and rip the Dixie cups right off of there and cut them out with an X-Acto knife. Now, a new technique that I'm doing that makes better dice, in my opinion, is to only cut halfway through. I used to cut the silicone molds entirely in half, but that leaves a lot of mold lines. If you cut halfway through, it eliminates some of the chances of mold lines that you have to sand down later, and you can still get the dice out fairly easy. I'm going with my traditional Art and Glow resin. It's tried and true, and I'm making way too much of it. I do some experiments with the resin on the side, so I wanted to make extra of it. And you can see here, there's a ton of tiny little bubbles in there. That's perfect. It's great for testing this. And I also use 3 pipettes rather than 1 now. So while I'm using 1, I can squeeze it out. And as soon as I'm done with that resin, I put it back in and let it start absorbing resin and start pouring out of the other. It takes a while for the pipettes to actually suck up resin. Even though my resin's been sitting in a hot water bath while it was in its containers, it's just thick stuff and it's hard to soak up in those pipettes sometimes. Finally, we're ready to put the resin in the molds inside of the pressure pot, which was the whole point of the last video, so that we can get the bubbles out of the resin. Well, not out, but reduced to where we can't see them. So go ahead and fill that up with pressurized air, and then began the longest night of my life because I wanted these to work so bad. So a quick little recap, this is exactly why we're using this whole vacuum chamber thing. If you don't have a vacuum chamber, tiny little bubbles will pop inside of your silicone molds and your resin will find its way in there when you use a pressure pot. If you're not using a pressure pot, I've never had issues, but dun da da da, look at this! Holy crap, it's perfectly crystal clear dice. I love it. I'm so happy with this result. It's been weeks, I had a freaking car accident in the meantime, and I just, everything was trying to make this not happen, so I'm so happy that this is finally done. Look at how clear those are. The only reason they're not as clear as glass is because I've been rubbing my fingers all over them going, wow, look how clear these are. So you can see a bunch of fingerprints and smudges on them. But dang, those are exactly what I wanted for. This whole thing was super duper worth it. I've got clear dice now. Though these are clear and not red, you can still see the difference between the red one here. You can get a ton of bubbles on these things. The pressure pot fixes that, or like this one where it's more of the green color. It's a huge difference. And these molds that I have are now reusable, so I can do it over and over and over again. So I'm completely happy with these. And now here's the comparison from Austin's paint on method. This is significantly less surface bubbles, and I'm not saying his results are not valid and sound, but I didn't receive the same results. Maybe I had my pressure too high, whatever. If somebody else can replicate it, great. It's a much cheaper alternative than using a vacuum chamber. And here's kind of the progression of this whole experiment. Originally on the left was the one without any pressure. That red one was the first pressure one I did that had all the surface bubbles. I said, all right, I'll try it again. The green one had surface bubbles. And I said, oh crap, that's not working. Here's Austin's one, second to the right. And then the final clear set here is all set and good to go. I decided, you know what, I gotta do something with these, and so I painted rainbow stuff on them, and I just missed Pride Month, but hey, here you go. Here's a rainbow set of dice. Thank you so much to everybody in the comments down below who said they were waiting for part 2 and really excited for this series. I was wondering if anybody really was interested, and you are, so I really like it when you guys interact below. Now we can start making all sorts of different dice that people have suggested in the comments, so please suggest different types of dice, and I will try and get to them the best I can. Consider subscribing if you like learning how to make different things for your tabletop, like dice and terrain, and maybe share this with somebody else who you might want to make some dice with. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys have a great day.